serena. Y el pueblo madrileño de una chuleta. Aprovecha.
Ay, 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 ay And as my grandmother narrated some of her story, Shia Hibara, and what happened after the hurricane of 1928, I remember that story, and it is significant to those of us that came in the 40s and the 50s. So please bear with me as I do the stance of resistance.
Mira. Miranda. Conocer Oscar López Rivera es conocer la dignidad del pueblo puertorriqueño. And I just read a message that he wrote last year when we were commemorating the 34th anniversary. We were having a march here in New York City, and he wrote a message. And I read it the other day. And in the message, he talks about how he combats hopelessness and how he fortifies himself. And I just think that no matter how hard things may occur to us, that if Oscar, after 35 years, can still see the possibility of a free and independent and thriving Puerto Rico. That it is our responsibility, it is our duty to have the same hope and in a defiant way. So yes, let's fight and let's hold on to that inner strength and not succumb to hopelessness and not succumb to despair and not succumb to any kind of anger that is self-destructive, but an anger that will motivate us. And what we need to do is to bring our brother home. We need to bring Oscar López Rivera home. So next Friday, I'm inviting all of you. I have tickets. We're having a freedom dance. It's going to support his campaign, his legal fees, and all of those essential things that are a part of bringing him home. And this is for Oscar and for all of us. And Leticia requested this poem specifically, and Dr. Drum is gonna back me up. Mira mi cara puertorriqueña, a mi pelo vivo, a mis manos morenas. Mira mi corazón que se llena de orgullo y dime que no soy boricua. Some people say that I'm not the real thing. Boricua, that is. Because I wasn't born on the Enchanted Island. Because I was born on the mainland north of Spanish Harlem. Because I was born in the Bronx. Some people think that I'm not bona fide. Because my playground was a concrete jungle. Because my Rio Grande de Luisa was the Bronx River. Because my Fajardo was City Island. My Luquillo, Orchard Beach. And summer nights were filled with city noises instead of coquines. And Puerto Rico was just some paradise that we only saw in pictures. What does it mean to live in between? What does it take to realize that being Boricua is a state of mind, a state of heart, a state of soul? Mira mi cara, Puerto Rico.
Thank you.